加入个电影，就是在圣诞那个播，叫《百态的秀》，叫电影的 Breakfast for Champion， which is the Eurasian section。And our first director will be the English Toastmaster G.C. Wellington。
Good evening.
It's my pleasure and my privilege to share my opinion of Augustine's third speech, Get to the Point. In this particular speech, he is asked to focus on what does he want to talk about, especially get to the point, the basic of why are you speaking. So in this, I'm going to give a basic review on the assignment manual and my impression of the host.There are two parts they ask for. One is what is general purpose, and in this particular place, general purpose inform. He wants to tell us about something, how to be great. That's quite clear. His specific purpose more interesting. He selected how to be great in your own personal life. That's an interesting topic. How well did you do this? Your essays, Augustine, am I getting it correct? The pronunciation, Augustine, is it? Right, I'm worried about that. A-U is an R-A-R, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes.So your assets are, you're very confident. Your years, your age 22 belies your confidence. You're very confident. You are poised. You are very fluent in your conversation. You've got good voice control. And you're pronouncing your voice and you're enunciating everything correctly. That's very nice. You're confident. That is undeniable. That's one of your strengths. The other part of your strength is you don't think small. I like your topic. It's greatness, clear cut. And you went through it. I want all of you to be great.Now, as you went through your speech, one thing struck me, you were reached very high. I was interested also, everybody, all of us want to be great, including me. And you spoke about how you went to overseas, New York, I believe, is it?
London,
sorry. And then one across one river to another, one ocean to the other. You spoke about your experiences there, how you pushed yourself to meet older people and younger people and so forth.And this is where I felt perhaps you could have improved a little bit. If your specific purpose was to teach us how to be great, may I suggest and give more examples of how you practice it in your own life? You said it, but you only gave a bits and pieces, snippets. I was expecting a little bit more. And in your case also, if I may suggest, because you're 22 years old,And you are talking to people who are gray in their hair, a lot of gray hair, and the Chinese say, I give it more salt than you kind of thing. You better have more facts. So the best way to take the approach, I'm not saying it's wrong, but share more of your experiences. And I believe your timing is also not sufficient. I did not see the green light being come on even. That means less than 5 minutes. You are wasting the additional 2.5 minutes. So may I suggest that you put in,more details of how you carried out your program of self-development. I'm sure all of us want to hear. I want to hear that. How did you as a young man go to London and make yourself talk to people to become great? That's great. That's very to be learned from everywhere, young, old, or in between. So give more of your life. So in that aspect, I thought your assignment could be improved with respect to your specific purpose. That is to teach us how to be great,by sharing your own example. But all in all though, I thought it's a very good start. I thought you were very confident, and I look forward to better speeches, greater speeches in the future. I thank you so much, and I look forward to the next speech. Thank you, Mr. Karen Valley.
Thank you, Mr. So that I feel just you think that this situation is very constructive.Start with one objective and slowly go point by point. And it's very encouraging and giving some point, which is expected from a very seasonal postmaster. So let's give a round of applause to this. Next, I'd like to invite the duration for second speaker, computer communicator Jack.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to give invitation to Lee Boon Wei. Boon Wei, I see a couple of your speeches. I see improvement in every of the speeches you give, especially this one. He is smooth. Let me start off with some of the good things that I've observed. You have a good intro. You start off with Malaysian food. I thought we're going to go into food. I'm almost drooling when you talk about gentle durian, which I've been waiting for. Suddenly, it matched your... There was twist, like what your title is yummy, but then cholesterol. You were saying you were like bringing up some of the nutrition facts. For example, if you eat, I don't know, a pack or a small drop of nasi lemak, you get 600 calories, and then you get 118 the fat, and 219 of the carbohydrate. I think this is very detailed. It's enough to scare me. I will take one last packet next time when I in the contest or something. I will just maybe eat half of the nasi lemak. So it's good you give some facts so people realize that how bad the food is that they are eating. Then you introduce cholesterol. You're asking anyone of the audience know what is cholesterol. And I don't know, but I deliver the same speech before last time. I know cholesterol, but some of the audience I see their face maybe a little bit confused. So even though you explain, later you explain like good cholesterol and bad cholesterol, HDL and LDL. And then you did ask a question to the audience, how much cholesterol you need per day, was it? Yeah. But I don't know, maybe I didn't get it or what happened. I didn't hear the answer, like how much cholesterol you really need to take per day. So you give an audience into some, maybe no answer, right? Because you have to indicate like facts. According to Minister of Health Malaysia, our cholesterol intake per day should be blah 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 like this. Just for example, since this is your research, your topic. And you also, but it's a good approach, you ask questions. You will like keep all this intact. So keep your speech more interesting. And also, you share about your personal experience. You were shocked by the health report that you did recently. Your cholesterol will jump. Again, we don't know what's the borderline for cholesterol. Also, maybe you should like let us know like, what is the borderline of the cholesterol. Because maybe I got a 10, I thought I low, you know. So I thought people, how about people do or whatever. So maybe that's a point for you to take home. And you also mentioned cholesterol is not that bad at all. Excess cholesterol will bad for the body. Maybe you should put a quote like by who, something like that, by Moon Wei, whatever. So overall, it's good. So that's just some room for improvement for me. And thank you. Back to you, Jennifer.
Thank you so much.
Jack, you have a very well thought duration and very specific. And I do agree with the point that you, when you say about the sources, it's better to quote that you say there's one quote, there's a survey. We say, according to Minister of Health survey. So which thing I think Jack is very spot on the duration. And I think you'll be very good duration as time goes by. Next, I'd like to welcome the Filipino Pastor Dr. King to be our third speaker. Let's give a round of applause.
Thank you, General Inventor Darrell. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today is indeed my pleasure to be able to evaluate Advanced Communicator Silver Kelvin Lim on the presentation of a Leadership Excellence Series. What Kelvin presented, ladies and gentlemen, is not a material of his own, but is actually a material from Toastmasters International, which he has customized to share a very important topic called Motivating People. Kelvin, I found that you were adequately prepared for this presentation because you definitely had no notes in hand. You were able to convey this very important message through the slides that were prepared by you, customized with a lot of adequate as well as relevant pictures. I found that the way you use dialogue and role play, especially with the audience, allowed us to encapsulate the ideas that you want us to take home. You were able to even make use of Jack, in essence, as the controller, so you will not be too heavily distracted by managing the presentation yourself. And lastly, you you were able to deliver everything within a 10 minutes 20 second session. Let's give Kelvin a round of applause. If you permit me to share some points for improvement, perhaps this is something that we can help to enhance the understanding of this topic as well as the presentation. First and foremost, unfortunately, the TME or yourself did not really share what was this presentation about. G. Levine or TME just shared that Kelvin Lim motivating people, and then he basically pushed you onto the stage. But why are you presenting this topic? Why is it important for us to know motivation techniques? Why is it important for us to listen to you as a speaker? Have you been a successful motivator? Perhaps these are points which you could have perhaps given to Naveen to spice up your introduction. So when people come up, oh, Kelvin Lim is coming up. He's going to share with us this topic, and he is an experienced motivator. So point of improvement on the introduction. Number two is that while it is good to have a person to control your slides for you, it is, in my personal opinion, sometimes you need to be able to control it yourself. Because sometimes when you have key points that you wish to go back to, the person controlling, unless you have done numerous rehearsal with him, may not know what is your signals. We keep hearing nicks, nicks, and nicks. So Jack just basically press nicks. But if you were able to have the notebook in front of you, or you can have a presenter, then you can have full control. But that's just my personal thought. Whether it's important for you to have full control. Lastly, I perhaps think that it's a bit too many slides. I understand the importance of customizing each slide for each point. But it then made me feel that there was just too many slides and you're skimming through. Sometimes, perhaps, you can have 3 points in one slide, so that animation can come on and we just focus on those keywords rather than the pictures. But overall, I believe this is a very important topic. You shared it well. With this bunch of improvement, I hope we can bring it up to another level and share us another important topic. Thank you, Kelvin, and back to you.
Thank you, Larry.
Well spot. There are 3 good points, I think that point that we start off with a very good encouraging message. And if I may add, you may tell what you want to tell, because your point is that if too many points, I cannot keep up and you know, good structure. This is my opinion, but you can say what you want to tell. The next director I like to invite is Tyron Lee.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters.
Good evening.
Actually, I should thank Ceiling for giving the chance to marry my mentees, AG, for doing your maiden speech. Frankly speaking, after tonight, I know you better. If you do not share with us that you are a quiet and introvert person, we really cannot, you know, imagine that. Because today you actually can, you know, project a very confidence level to us. When you stand in front, you start to share about yourself. So your confidence level is there, and you are a natural person. Easy to engage with others. This is the strength of the mouth. So another thing that also one of the important points to engage with the audience is that humorous. And then during your sharing, I find that you are quite humorous to engage with the audience so that the audience is still with you. Because to let the audience to maintain the attention with us, that's quite humorous to make the important development. Okay. Some of the areas, I think, but these areas are for improvement is mainly you will learn in the next few speeches. So perhaps I just based on your creative speech, you can take a look at this area. First is your standing position. Because you choose not to use the letters and stand in front of the audience. So perhaps you can make sure that you stand a little bit high so that the audience, like Henry and Mary side, you can the eye contact, you can deal with that. Because just now you stand a bit front. So maybe this So another thing is the eye contact. Because in order to engage with the audience, eye contact just start with the standard here, and then most of the time you just concentrate on the class of things. So perhaps you can, next time you can just can look at the left, then move, and then look at the right. Because eye contact is actually to capture the attention of things. So basically, I really like the message in the conclusions that we have to believe in ourselves. And break through our own discretions is something that that we have to keep on remind ourselves. Thank you. Looking for your next speech.
Iteration of C1 is the most important iteration ever. Because if you say very harsh, the speaker will never hear. And so, have you motivated to keep on pictures?
Thank you for your support.
So this means he has done a very good evaluation because he has encouraged the speaker to pick even more. Let's give a round of applause. So today we have all our amazing director. Can everything go for the best evaluation?